Now, let's step back and talk, Patrice, about the organization Black Lives Matter. It's not something that just started this summer. You and your fellow organizers, Opal Tometi and Alicia Garza, started this organization, what, 2 years ago?
Last year,
Oh, last year.
after
Okay, so
Trayvon,
two.
after George Zimmerman acquittal.
And so where did that, how did you come up with this phrase? What are the origins of this phrase that has now become a rallying cry among a few other rallying cries, such as Hands Up, Don't Shoot, and I Can't Breathe?
So, Trayvon Martin was murdered, and George Zimmerman was not arrested at first, and then he was arrested after the family, really pushed for the Florida Police Department to arrest him. And then we waited to see what was going to happen, if he was going to be convicted of murder. And we witnessed Trayvon Martin go on trial. We witnessed his character be slandered. And the day of the verdict, which was July 13th, a Saturday, I was in Susanville. I was visiting one of my mentees at the state prison. And I came home and I went on Facebook. There was no TV in the hotel room, motel room. And folks on Facebook started to say he was acquitted. And I just lost it. I was crying and disturbed. And I was like, if we have all this evidence that this young man was hunted by George Zimmerman, and yet George Zimmerman still gets off the hook, well, what does our lives mean, right?
And in many ways, then these young men and women like Trayvon Martin, like Mike Brown and Eric Garner symbolize like all our children.
Precisely, precisely. And yes, exactly. And I think for me, it was just this intense amount of grief that came over me. But I'm also an organizer, and so I quickly move my grief into action.
Don't mourn, organize. Yeah,
Exactly.
yeah, yeah.
And I move my grief into action, and I just started going on social media and writing black people and saying that I love them and checking on other black people, how are you? And myself and Alicia Garza got into a Facebook sort of conversation. And she said this thing where she essentially said to black folks in particular who were saying, we should have known better. Of course, they were gonna treat us this way. She started saying to folks, I'm always gonna be surprised. I'm never going to let them numb me from saying that our lives don't matter. And she said, our lives matter, black lives matter. And then under the Facebook thread, I hashtagged Black Lives Matter. And so from there, literally in that moment, it was like a light bulb for so many black people on social media at that point. And I started tagging black folks saying, your life matters, black lives matter, and started tagging all my black friends. I got on the phone with her that night. And we said we want this to be a project. And so the very next day on July, I think, no, it was a couple days later, July 15th, Riku Matsuda from Flip the Script here
Yes.
called me on to be on a show. And I was going to talk about Black Lives Matter. So it happened very organically. Soon enough, Alicia was on HuffPo Live talking about Black Lives Matter. We ended up seeing Law and Order did a whole segment, a weird mashup of Trayvon Martin and Paula Deen. And there was a protest. It was very weird. But someone had a Black Lives Matter sign in the protest. And so we knew that it was doing something out in the world for black folks. We did a huge protest in Beverly Hills, where we shut down Beverly Hills a few days after Trayvon, the acquittal of George Zimmerman. We had all these Black Lives Matter signs. And so I think both the hashtag blew up on social media, but also blew up in the streets. And we saw lots of folks sort of holding these signs and utilizing them in their cities. And then fast forward, Mike Brown's murdered. And then I think St. Louis and Ferguson really took the Black Lives Matter piece to the next level. We have our Black Lives Matter ride where we organize over 600 people, and all those folks go back to their communities and continue Black Lives Matter in their own city.